The story behind Willy the Jeep and the entire Jeep a Week program is a tribute to the people of Stockton and their unique contribution to the national war effort during the Second World War. The United States entered the war in December of 1941, and by 1942, they were trying to encourage students to invest in war stamps. And then a gentleman by the name of Mitch Lewis, who taught agricultural science at Stockton High School, came up with an idea. He knew that the port of Stockton had been taken over by the military, and it was to become the largest vehicle and parts consignment center in the entire United States during the Second World War. So they had a lot of vehicles, including a lot of Jeeps. So he went to the powers that be out at the port and said, if our students come up with the $900 that a Jeep cost to build at that time, will you give them credit and can we acknowledge their purchase by putting a little plaque on each Jeep? They said yes. And from January of 1943 until September of 1945, the students of Stockton High School raised the equivalent today of $3 million to purchase a fleet of 275 Jeeps. Over the years of the war, letters and plaques would come back to the students, and some of the letters were extremely touching. The one that I remember is a serviceman is writing back to the students and saying, you can imagine my surprise when I got a ride on this Jeep and I climbed in, sat in the front seat and looked down and saw the plaque, and turns out I'm a graduate of Stockton High School 3 years earlier. And plaques came in, letters kept coming in until after the war, and they sat kind of unrecognized for quite some time. The war was over, people moved on. In the 1970s, the principal of Stockton Junior High, which is what Stockton High School had become, a gentleman by the name of Arch Brown, received a letter from a fellow in Texas, last name of McClellan, who said he had one of Stockton's Jeep. He had seen the plaque. That's why he wanted to communicate with Stockton High School. And so they communicated over the years. Finally, Mr. McClellan said that his son had been injured in an automobile accident. He needed to raise some money for medical expenses. So he wanted to give first right of refusal to the people of Stockton to get one of their Jeeps back. The funds were raised, they purchased the Jeep, and it came to the museum in the late 1970s. And while it was on display, visitors would point out some of the inaccuracies in the reconstruction of the Jeep that had been done by Mr. McClellan. And finally, in the early 2000s, one of the museum's trustees, a gentleman by the name of Ross Bewley, took it upon himself to reconstruct the Jeep as it would have been done in 1944. And after about a year and $43,000, our originally $900 Jeep came back to us, but it has proven to be a gem and one of the real heroes of the museum's history collections, with visitors pointing out that it's one of the best reconstructed 1944 Jeeps that they've ever seen on display.